स्पीच रिकॉग्निशन एंड हाउ वॉइस रिकॉग्निशन, स्पीच रिकॉग्निशन, द एनालिसिस पार्ट एंड हाउ द एप्लीकेशंस आर देयर, व्हाट आर द मेथोडोलॉजीज, आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट इट. फाइन गाइस, सो दिस इज व्हाट द आउटलाइन ऑफ आवर डिस्कशन वुड बी, द प्रॉब्लम, व्हाट इज स्पीच फीचर्स. सो ऑल स्पीच एंड एवरीथिंग हैज टू बी डिजिटल, सो एनालिटिक्स कैन बी डन ओनली ऑन द this data part of it, so it has to be converted to a digital form. So what are these features which you need to so feature selection, various models I'll be talking about, your current state of ASR and the future plans for the automatic speech recognition. So when we talk about the definition of this speech recognition, it's an interdisciplinary field of computer science, computational linguistics that develop these methodologies and technologies that enable the recognition and translation of spoken language into text by computers. So that's the definition of the speech recognition. Speech recognition is also the capability of a electronic device to understand these spoken words. So a microphone records the person's voice. It's primarily the hardware that converts the signal from analog sound wave to a digital audio, and this audio data is then processed by the software. So we are talking about this speech recognition software, which interprets the sound as an individual words. It is also known as the, so these are the synonyms: automatic speech recognition, computer speech recognition, or speech to text, right? So we'll be using some of these words interchangeably. So some speech recognition systems require training, and these are also called as enrollment. So it trains the system. You have to make the system learn where an individual speaker reads the text or isolated vocabulary into the system. So, and the system analyzes the person's specific voice, tone, and uses it to fine tune and recognition of that person's speech, resulting in increased accuracy. So the systems that do not use the training are called the speaker independent systems, and systems that use training are called speaker dependent systems. Fine guys, so the term voice recognition, so this is specifically to identify the speaker. So the voice recognition or the speaker identification refers to identifying the speaker rather than what they are saying. So it's not concerned with the text part of it, it is the pitch and tone of the speaker, and to identify who that person is, so which is called the voice recognition. And recognizing the speaker can simplify the task of translating speech in systems. So every speaker has a peculiar style of speaking, right? And if the system has already understood about the capability or the trend of that speaker, so ultimately, it will identify how that person and what is the tone of that person. So some of the words which may be an error for the system, but it understands for that particular speaker, it is this meaning, right? So accordingly, based on the training of that particular speaker's voice, it can then be used to authenticate or verify the identity of the speaker as part of the security process. So many of the laptops, or you just speak some certain words, and accordingly, it will synthesize the word and convert it and take it as a security. So voice recognition, face recognition, lot of security aspects people have implemented in their systems. So from the technology perspective, speech recognition has a long history with several ways of, so a lot of work has already gone into the system, and the field has been benefited with advanced deep learning and the big data. So because a lot of data can be stored at the back end, so big data and deep learning technologies help the speech recognition. Now I'll be talking about some of these applications. Some of you have already are aware of it, but just to summarize, this speech recognition applications can use the voice user interface, such as like dictation is the most common use of automatic speech recognition systems, right? Voice calling, like call home, or you do that in your mobiles. So that's how system understands the voice recognition. Call routing, so I would like to make a group call or something, so accordingly it will route the calls according to the group. Some EPBX's voice mail systems allow callers to speak commands instead of pressing buttons, right? So you can record the voice accordingly. It does the actions. Domestic application controls, search keywords like a podcast where particular words are spoken, it identifies and picks up those keywords and accordingly it saves into the data. Simple data entry can be done, entering a credit card. You just keep speaking out and it enters the data. Similarly, preparation of a structured document, any of the kind of a radiology report or something, reports can be created using the voice recognition. Determining the speaker characteristics, the tone of the voice, right? Angry, harsh, whatever, soft, happy, those kind of emotions can be characterized. Speech to text processing, word processors, emails, typing in the data. Even on your mobile, you do that, right? You keep speaking and that text gets converted, voice gets converted into text. In the aircrafts, usually termed the direct voice input. So the other applications could be the recent one where aerospace in the space exploration, NASA's Mars Polar Lander used the speech recognition technology from this company in the Mars microphone on the lander. So accordingly, it try to understand the speech recognition in that area. Automatic subtitling with speech recognition. Emotion recognition, right? So this is what I was talking about. Automatic translation. Even the courts have started using so court reporting, real-time speech writing. So judges is speaking out and then it is getting converted into text and you can use it. Even courts have started using it. E-discovery, so these legal discoveries, hands-free computing or home automation. So these are lot of use cases available. Mobile telephony, which includes your mobile emails, interactive voice response, pronunciation evaluation in computer. So even some of these TOEFL and all exams, it goes through this speech to text and all those technologies, and based on the pronunciation, it evaluates your and gives you the marks. Real time captioning, so some speech is going on and underline, you will see the captioning of the complete speech. UN speech, when it is delivered, it is always converted into local languages. Robotics, security. So you can use multi-factor authentication using biometric scanners or speech or even speech to text, right? So I have talked about it. Telematics, the vehicle navigation system, you would see, you speak something and accordingly it identifies the location and gives you the direction. Transcriptions, digital speech to text. And even the most recent ones, virtual assistants like Apple, Siri, Alexa, they have all started using the speech analytics. So to give you some of the details about this, in-car systems application could be like, so all new cars coming would be all using the audio prompts, right? So you say something and it understands and does that. Call home, right? It does, it understands. It's always listening and it does the action. Or run FM 92.7. So it does that. Accordingly, it connects to radio and tunes into 92.7. Simple voice commands, right? So they can be run into various music systems. Some of the most recent car models offer natural language speech recognition in place of the fixed set of commands. So some of the vehicles, they use fixed set commands. So it understands only a set of 10-15 commands and accordingly it will do that. But some of the latest technologies are using the natural language speech recognition systems, which primarily understands the complete text and does the whatever is relevant, it understands that and allows the driver to use full sentences and common phrases. Very important use cases in the healthcare. So in the healthcare sector, the speech recognition can be implemented in front end. And what is front end and back end in the medical documentation process? So front end speech recognition is where the provider dictates into a speech recognition engine and recognize words are displayed as they are spoken. And the dictator is responsible for editing and signing of that document. So that's a front end speech recognition. And what is that back end or deferred speech recognition system? Where the provider dictates into a digital dictation system. So it is a back end process. So transcripting and a lot of speech recognition machines translate that. Whatever doctors are speaking, it translates that into and records as part of the patient's record. Right? So accordingly, it is done that way. So, but there are certain issues also. One of the major issues relating to the use of speech recognition is the healthcare. Is the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act of 2009, which provides the substantial financial benefit to physicians who utilize the EMR according to meaningful use standards. So these standards require that a substantial amount of data to be maintained by the EMR. So EMR was earlier used, now it is called Electronic Health Record, EHR. And the use of speech recognition is more naturally suited to the generation of this narrative text as part of the radiology pathology interpretation. So a lot of work is going on in this direction. Another healthcare is where benefits into short-term memory re-strengthening in brain AVM patients. So those who forget very fast, so they are, for them this cognitive benefits for these individual are being used to be treated using the radiology techniques. Medical disabilities people, so many people have difficulty typing due to physical limitations, right? So because of that, they can then speak and then it can be converted into text. Defense again is a very promising field for the use of speech recognition. So high performance fighter aircraft, right? So it's a second activity, right? You would understand the complexity of how fast the fighter pilot has to take an action. So if he is able to speak and the action can be done. So it depends on how accurate you want or what are the areas which action can be done, right? If you say weapon, drop the weapon, or you are just, so there are areas where it cannot take an action, right? So let's take an example of this fighter aircraft. Particular note has been by the US program to speech recognition for the advanced fighter technology integration in F-16s. The program in France for Mirage aircraft and other programs in the UK dealing with variety of the aircraft platforms. In these programs, speech recognizer has been operated successfully in the fighter aircraft, which applications which include setting of radio frequency. So you can speak and set the radio frequency, commanding an autopilot system, right? Setting a steer point coordinates and weapon release also, weapon release parameters and controlling the flight display. So there are only few planes or fighter planes have this weapon release parameter. So it is against a security. So it and nobody can speak and it will drop the vehicle weapon. So it has to understand the voice very powerfully. It has to be the same pilot who has the authority. So accordingly, it will do that. Working with this Swedish pilot flying in this particular Gripen cockpit, the report concluded that adaption greatly improved the results in all cases, and the introduction of a model of breathing was shown to improve the recognition scores significantly. So people are doing a lot of effort in automating the speech recognition into these military aircrafts. Helicopters, that is again a very challenging one. Why? Because lot in aircrafts, at least the voice is, it's a acoustics are the surroundings are less, But in helicopters, these are all open one, and the noise problem is acute. So accordingly, you have to that mask, face mask has to be there. But in general, these pilots do not wear a face mask. So surrounding is quite high, and then you have to speak, and accordingly, the system should identify your voice also. So that's the challenge, and people are working to work on this technology. Another area is training on the air traffic controllers, ATCs. So they have to take a, they are very fast people. In seconds, they have to decide that there is a enemy plane behind you, or you are behind a enemy plane, right? Something of that sort, and quickly they have to take a call. So training for air traffic controllers. So at least for the training part, they've started using the speech recognition. So training on air traffic controllers represents an excellent application for this speech recognition system. Many ATC training systems currently require a person to act as a pseudo-pilot, engaging in a voice dialogue with the trainee controller. So some person is training, and that there are trainees available. So which simulates the dialogue from the controller, which would have to be conducted with pilots in the real-time ATC. So speech recognition and synthesis techniques offer a potential to eliminate the need of a person to act as a pseudo-pilot. So automated, as if you are part of, you are guiding the ATC, and trainees are listening to it, and accordingly they are acting. So lot of air forces and air traffic controls, they have started using the ATC simulators. They have started using the speech recognition. Telephony, again, so IVRs, you have seen interactive voice response systems. According to what you speak, it takes a next call, right? I want to speak to the help desk. So accordingly, I need to talk to the technology person, right? So accordingly, it will divert to the technology team. So a lot of smartphones are already available. Speech recognition applications in the education vertical. Right, even student learning can be enhanced by for learning a second language, another language. Right, it can teach a proper pronunciation, the tone, the fluency of the and the speaking skills can be enhanced using the speech recognition. So it will continuously keep the improving the and the second language, another language. So students can learn another language using the speech recognition. Other exception cases are students who are blind or have very low vision can be benefited by using these technologies to convey words and then hear the computer recite them. So accordingly, so speech to text, and then accordingly the computer is reciting back to them. Students who are physically disabled, who are not able to type, handwriting, typing is a problem, they can speak to text programs can convert their speech, and then accordingly the actions can be taken. Speech recognition can also allow students with learning disabilities. So those who learn slow, they can also use speech recognition. So a lot of use cases are there. And people with disabilities, anyway, I've talked about that they can use speech recognition to convert into speech to text. And finally, from computer, it can convey or it can take an action accordingly. So okay, so the performance of this speech recognition system is evaluated in terms of accuracy. So these are measured with accuracy and speed. So I'm now coming to the technical part of it. Those were the use cases and some of the examples of the speech recognition. Now we'll go into the details of what are these factors which govern the speech recognition system, and these are all evaluated in accuracy and speed. So accuracy is usually related with word error rate, WER, whereas speed is measured with the real-time factors. And some of the other measures of accuracy includes the single word error rate and the command success rate. So we'll be using these words, and the speech recognition by machine is it's primarily a very complex problem, and visualization vary in terms of accent. See the variety: accent, pronunciation, roughness, the pitch, the volume, the speed. Some people speak very fast, right? Some people speak very slow, right? So it has to understand all the complexities. So speech is distorted by the background. You would hear a person doing some work, right? So some hammering is going on at the back end. So you would hear those noises. So yeah, so these systems should eliminate those background noises. So accuracy of the speech recognition varies with the following: the vocabulary size and the confusability, right? So it has to, so language has to speak itself. So, so, do, do. So those are the confusing words. It has to understand and it has to read, and so it has to learn from what you speak. Accordingly, it has to take an action. Speaker dependence versus independence. The system should understand with the without speaker also, right? Isolated, discontinuous. So I'll be talking about these task and language constraints. Read versus spontaneous speech, adverse conditions. So when we talk about the accuracy part, accuracy of speech recognition may vary depending on the following factors. Let's say error rate, which increases as the vocabulary size grows. So, so this is the understanding that error rate increases as the vocabulary size grows, right? So example is, let's say 10 digits 0 to 9 can be recognized essentially perfectly, right? So 0 to 9. But as the vocabulary size increases, let's say 200 words, 5,000 words, 10,000, so it will have the error rate increase from 3% to 7% to 45%. So as the size of this vocabulary is increased, the error rate also increases. So vocabulary is hard to recognize if it contains some confusing words. Like in English, 26 letters of the English alphabets are difficult to discriminate, because you would see some of these notorious characters. These are called E sets. B, C, D, E, right? G, P, T, V, Z. They're all similar looking. So based on the tone of the speaker, the system may get confused whether it is B or Z or G, right? Accordingly, it will get confused. So there is a 8% error is considered to be a good for any vocabulary. Fine. So speaker dependence and independence, so requires the system, this person to speak or not. Accordingly, they are classified as speaker dependence or independence. Another word is called isolated, discontinuous, or continuous speech. So isolated speech is single words are used, some actions are there. Therefore, it becomes easier to recognize these speeches. Isolated words, call home, right? So, right, connect 92.7. So it does that. So these are isolated speeches. And with a discontinuous speech, full sentence separated by silence are used. Therefore, it becomes easier to recognize the speech as well as the isolated speech. And with continuous speech, it is hard because it is continuous. You do not understand whether there is comma, full stop. Accordingly, it may change the tone of the or action of also. So, roko mat jane do. Roko mat jane do. So these are two sentences which are generally opposite in nature now, right? Where the comma is, roko, comma, mat jane do. So the person has asked somebody to stop somebody and do not allow. But he understood, roko, mat, comma, jane do. Action is entirely different. So you need to understand where that comma, full stop is. So accordingly, the tone, the pitch. So it becomes very hard to recognize these kind of continuous speeches. So read versus spontaneous. So these are some of the keywords that you should read about. Okay, so I'll just quickly move on to the next one. the accuracy. So this is a kind of a mathematics, or I would say how to come up with a formula for the accuracy part. So when you digitize the speech, they are so for telephone speech, the sampling rate is 8,000 samples per second kind of. So compute the features of the spectral domain of the speech and compute every 10 milliseconds. So understand the telephony speech analytics. So how fast it has to do the analysis. So basic sound create waves that have two descriptions, the amplitude and the frequency. So amplitude is how strong it is, and the frequency is how often it vibrates per second kind of, right? We all understand amplitude and frequency. And accuracy can be computed with the help of word error rate, which we have discussed earlier. So this word error rate can be calculated by aligning the recognized word and referred word using the dynamic string alignment. So the problem may occur while computing the word error rate due to the difference between the sequence length of the recognized word and the reference word. So let's assume that S is the number of substitutions, D is the number of deletions in the word, I be the number of insertions in the system, and N is the total number of word references. So the formula for computing the word error rate is S plus D plus I divided by total number of words, right? So total number of words substituted or deleted or inserted, the sum of them divided by total number of words gives you the word error rate. So while computing the word recognition rate, so this is 1 minus that value, which is 1 minus word error rate. So it becomes 1. So when you do that formula, it becomes N minus S minus D minus I divided by N. And this can be represented by N minus S minus D is represented by H. And what is H? Is the number of correctly recognized words. So these are the correctly recognized words. Total number minus S is substitutions and D is deletions. So which has been deleted and substituted are the actual recognized words. Fine, guys. Okay, so speech recognition also gives you some security concerns, right? So the speech recognition can become a means of attack, theft, or accidental operations. I remember one case was there when a toy which was able to communicate, right, to the, so somebody hacked that toy, and as if that toy was speaking, that guy was trying to send that message and connected to that the small kid and asked, what is your name? That guy, small kid, gave his name. What is your parents, mother's name, father's name, right? Where do you stay? Is your mom at home now, right? So that way he was able to collect a lot of information from that small kid, and accordingly they did a theft in that area, in that house. So lot of security concerns are there because of this voice recognition. The device itself, that toy, was not taken, that security aspects were not taken care of, and actually it was hacked, and then mishappening happened. So this speech recognition can become a means of attack, theft, or accidental operations. So while we are developing applications, the one of our concerns are about the security. And when you are developing a software, you have to take care of the security at your IoT level. If you are, it's a complete system I'm talking about, you have to take care of the security of IoT, the edge devices. If your communication is secured over internet, right, HTTPS or 128-bit encryption or 256-bit encryption, if it is a e-commerce portal, then when your network is there, so your server has to be HTTPS, right? Then your database or the application itself, the ports do not have to be open. The application itself has to be secured. No vulnerabilities in the system. your database connectivity has to happen in a secure connection way. So everywhere you have to take care of the security concerns. So even this speech recognition also has a so these voice control devices are also accessible to visitors to the building, or even those outside the building if they can be heard inside, right? So as there are many use cases, try to learn from the security concerns about the speech recognition. Attackers may be able to gain access to the personal information like calendar, address book, content, private messages, documents through this speech recognition. They may also be able to impersonate the user to send messages or make online purchases. So there was an example wherein the wife or the speaker was able to say, and because the refrigerator was an intelligent one, it would order it based on the voice of the owner. It could order some of the groceries. So that was one of the issue where one of the speaker was made to speak in a way that as if it is a owner of the house, and accordingly it was understood by the refrigerator, and the order to Amazon was placed. So you can think of how speech recognition can be treated as a security concern also, right? So now with these issues and concerns, we'll move on to the various models, the various methods and the algorithms of the speech recognition. So guys, in case you have any questions, or am I fast, am I slow, or is it understood, I'll be able to move forward. Any questions till now, guys? So I'll be taking one demo, an example of the speech recognition analytics using R language. So just focus on that as well. It will take half an hour to. I have that program running, so I'll move quickly to that R program for practical example of speech recognition and the analytics part of it. So how a sentiment analysis can be done, right? A descriptive analysis can be done using the speech to text, and then finally the sentiment analytics. So both acoustic model and the language modeling are important part of the this modern statistical speech based recognition algorithm. So one of the algorithms is called hidden Markovian model, which is widely used in many systems, and the language model is also used in many other natural language processing applications such as document classification or statistical machine translation. So we'll be learning a bit about hidden Markovian model. So when we talk about hidden Markovian model, so the modern general purpose speech recognition system are based on this hidden Markovian model. These are the statistical models that output a sequence of symbols and quantities. So it's based on the symbols and quantities, and the hidden Markovian models are used in speech recognition because speech signals can be viewed as a piecewise stationary signal or a short time stationary signal. So in the short time scale, that means 10 milliseconds, speech can be approximated as a stationary process, and speech can be thought of as a Markovian model for many stochastic purposes. So I'll be talking about what is this Markovian model is. Another reason why the hidden Markovian model are popular is because they can be trained automatically and are simple and computationally feasible to use. So it's a standard, well documented algorithm, and those interested in it should go into the details of the algorithm. So in speech recognition, the hidden Markovian model would output a sequence of n-dimensional real value vector. So where n would be something around 8 to 10, right? Outputting one of these every 10 milliseconds. So the vectors would consist of coefficients which are obtained by taking the Fourier transformation of the short time window of speech and then decorrelating the spectrum using the cosine transforms, then taking the first coefficient. So these are few technical words, so you should learn about the Fourier transformation and the cosine transformation. So this hidden Markovian model will tend to have in each state of a statistical distribution, that is a mixture of diagonal covariance Gaussian methods, which will be give a likelihood of each observed vector. So a hidden Markovian model for a sequence of words in phenomena is made by concatenating the individual trained hidden Markovian model for separate words and phenomena. So another method is called dynamic time warping based speech recognition. So the dynamic time warping is an approach that was historically used for speech recognition, but has now been displaced by the more successful hidden Markovian model. Okay, so earlier it was the dynamic time warping based, but now everybody uses the HMM method. So what is dynamic time warping is an algorithm for measuring the similarity between two sequences that may vary in time or speed. So it measures the similarity. For instance, similarity in walking pattern would be detected even if the video of a person was walking slowly, or if it is in another, he or she may be walking quickly, or even if they were accelerated or deaccelerated, right, fast forwarded, then also the system would be able to identify it. So this dynamic time warping has been applied in video, audio, graphics, and any data that can be turned into a linear representation and which can be analyzed with this dynamic time warping. So a well-known application has been automatic speech recognition to cope up with different speaking speeds. In this method, that allows the computer to find an optimal match between the two given sequences, so the time series with certain restrictions. So the sequence are warped, not linearly to the match each other. So speed doesn't make a difference. It is the pattern of the walking, right, or pattern of the speech. So the sequence alignment method is often used in the context of hidden Markovian model. So ultimately, these all led to the HMM method. Another is a neural network method. So in neural network emerged as a attractive acoustic modeling approach in automatic speech recognition in 1980s. Since then, the neural network has been used in many aspects of speech recognition, such as phoneme classification through multi-objective evolutionary algorithm, isolated words recognition, audio-visual speech recognition, audio-visual speaker recognition, and recognition speakers adaptation. So it contains the complete spectrum, right? Audio-visual speech recognition, the speaker recognition, and the speaker adaptation kind of. So neural networks make fewer explicit assumptions about the features, statistical properties than the hidden Markovian model, and have several qualities making them attractive. So this is also used better than the HMM. So one approach of this limitation was to use neural network as a pre-processing, feature transformation, or dimension reduction method. So people have, what they have done, so they have used neural network and followed by the hidden Markovian model. So the combination is working well for the industry. So when you talk about the ASR, the automatic speech recognition problem, so